Hello!
Welcome.
Roger.
How are you doing?
This is our last of our followers. Amanda sent us via email.
Cheers, Amanda.
Yeah. There you go. It's the Passmasters 1966 Strong Ale. As you can see, it's probably the people that brewed it back in 1966.
Or is it the 1966 recipe?
No, well, it would be a recipe, but the people that actually brewed it.
The people there on that photograph.
Yeah. But let's crack it open. Old fashioned tankard, which I managed to get at a charity shop the other day. So let's get it poured into the glass. Nice, careful pour.
Caramel colour, almost, isn't it?
Yeah.
Caramel toffee look.
Don't want to pour too much, just want to do a shake and pour. But yeah, traditional English strong bitter colour. Slight bit like zesty orange.
Well, it says on back here, just giving a slight history lesson on the past masters' recipes on their beers and style of beer, brews and whatever. It's the 1966 strong ale. It's the fourth in their series. It's brewed by a strong ale recipe from 1966. It's drunk during the celebration of England's victory of the World Cup.
Very cool. I do a smell.
You kind of get some sort of like
fruit. It's not like Darth Vader, did it? Maybe it's started in there, though.
Probably a bit spirit. Yeah. But no, you get like a sort of a kind of fruity taste, sort of a, like, not cherry, but...
In fairness, we had the vintage the other week, and it was like, yeah. Well, this actually tastes better than the vintage. We also had the Imperial Stout from Fuller's, and that, like... Yeah, it got better near the end, but by then we were like going neck. But the initial taste is really nice.
You know, it's funny. This is a warming dark ruby ale as a rich.
Not really dark, is it?
I don't know, what was it? It's not my opinion. Rounded flavour notes of plum and velvet.
Velvet. Oh, okay.
And a warm caramel finish.
Right. Do that.
Sit. A bit more.
It's a lot more colour that's into the head now.
You see, there's a little bit more glazed colour. You know what I mean? It's kind of sweet.
Blowing bubbles. But this is probably the best Fuller's we've had for a while. But we haven't been blown away by these.
Yeah, that's
special bottles. I mean, I was mentioning earlier about the Imperial Stout. It came in this beautiful box, beautiful bottle, and we had it as like, the vintage came in a beautiful box, beautiful presentation. It's just.
It's quite tasty.
Yeah, it has that like proper beautiful bloom there.
You do get that like plum feel though, you know, really. Nice, sweet and subtle taste.
Yeah, it's really, really drinkable. It's a little bit better. I'd have to say it's probably best Fuller's I've had for a long time.
Would you find it sessionable?
Yeah, easy. I think...
It's 7.3.
I know. I think probably the best one I've ever had is probably the Passmasters Double Stout. That was really nice.
Yeah.
But since then... This is the best beer I've had since the Passmasters Double Stout.
Yeah.
That's right. We saw the Fuller's Lager in the supermarket the other day. And we were like, going, we're about to buy it. And then we realised we just had to about two or three fillers, and the last two or three fillers have been like blah.
Mm.
But the only one that stood out so far is the Past Masters Double Stout, and the Past Masters 1966 is another good hit.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying is, if you see fillers Past Masters, definitely mix them up.
Yeah, because didn't they do whiskey one or is that the other
that,
one?
That's the batch numbers, if I can't remember. I think we've had number two. We had the blue box, I think.
Because Amanda sent us the third one, was it? Or?
Yeah. It's Heritage Series, but yeah, if you see this...
Oh, is that the Brewer's Choice? Is that the Brewer's one?
Might be a Brewer's Choice.
Yeah.
Well, if you see this, buy this. You take care.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.